Now, the exercises are to be done away from music to establish normalcy as a person. And we do this by teaching inhalation and exhalation. There are simple studies. You can take anybody and have them blow their breath out until they're as empty as they can achieve. In other words, and then wait with empty lungs until a need for respiration occurs. In other words, when they're turning blue and beginning to suffer, then you take a huge yawn. That breath, after having denied yourself of respiration for 20, 30 seconds, is going to be enormous compared to your musical breath.
Earlier during the week, I gave one exercise where you inhale, maybe to the count of six, and exhale to the count of six. This should be done, or maybe it could be six or seven or eight steps while you're walking, or if you're sitting somewhere, you just conduct it. But it should be on the slow side, no faster than a second anyway, between beats. But from empty lungs, just like frog and tip in a violin bow, I want empty lungs reasonably, not completely empty, but comfortably empty, to massively filled, to where you inhale and kind of experience the air going in and out of the mouth. Illustration. You want to try that? Count 5-4. You blow out for four full beats. Then you replace the entire amount in the fifth beat, like this. Entire beat to replace that. See, this is not a study of the fast breath, but of the quantity. Use the whole beat. Should empty your lungs. That's it. Two, three, four. Now take the whole beat. That's it. Now you get the good breaths, right? Then after a week or two, you begin to add another one, which would be the same study, but done in much less time. You'd replace your breath. We'll say eighth notes on the, you'd exhale for 7/8 notes and inhale on one, the entire quantity. That's the whole purpose, is to know how much you've blown out and replace exactly what you've used up. We'll do it for two bars. Try. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four. One. So the eighth note on the F beat, but you're using the whole fourth beat. You should only use the last eight of it. One and two and three and four. The end is when you do it. These studies should be done before you practice. They should be done in the middle of your practice, and then at various times of the day you do it. So four, five, six times a day you do the respiratory work. So you never do a very long period of it at any time. We're not interested in building endurance with it. And we always have to take into consideration the fatigue factor that this can cause. And don't abuse yourselves, but also find the flexibility rather than strength of the respiratory system. Think of the forearm of your colleagues who play violin. In other words, you grab them by the arm. There's no fight between bicep and tricep. And we don't want a fight between inspiratory and expiratory musculature.